Hi guys, good morning. It's Sunday morning here in Boulder, Colorado. I've been staying at home with my wonderful family for like 2 weeks. No, it's actually been really great and really nice. I kind of got out of my sweatpants today, but I just changed into yoga clothes, so I don't know if that counts. But anyway, I'm feeling like a little disconnected from all of you, so I wanted to reach out and say, hey, how's it going? We're all going to get through this, and I just wanted to let you know that it might be a little more challenging to answer some of your one-on-one questions right away. I'm getting a lot of questions still, and Eve is also really busy responding to everyone, but I figured it would be easier if you have questions, you could ask them in the comments, and since so many of your questions are the same as other women's questions, I could respond in video and answer more than one of you at a time, and hopefully that will be helpful during this time. We're kind of changing it up. We're still trying to get your products out to you in a timely fashion. We're kind of quarantined at the fulfillment place, so great gratitude to all those people over there. It's just two of them packing up your stuff, and they're kind of being really, really careful and not seeing anybody either. So an interesting time. Hopefully you guys are doing all right and staying sane and are with people that you care about and love. So one of your most common questions that I want to touch on today is about both tube blockage and whether my products work if you've had your tubes tied. So a lot of you reach out as if you've only seen one tea, which is the Fertile Mama tea. That's definitely the most popular of my fertility teas. But I actually have a lot of other products and teas that would be more appropriate if your tubes are blocked. And usually women know that their tubes are blocked. They'll have a what's called an HSG test, a hysterosalpingogram, where they kind of put a like dye through and they check to see if the pathways are clear. And if they're not, they'll tell you that you have some tubal blockage. So the products that are in the tubal blockage bundle are blood and chi moving. That tends to be what gets stuck. You could also have some scar tissue there, and for that I recommend moxa. A few of you have asked for like a tutorial on how to use moxa, so this is the stick you will get in your bundle. But before we do that, I want to also touch on whether it works if you've had your tubes tied. And for that, it has worked for some women, but not enough for me to feel comfortable or confident telling you to go out and spend your money on this. It's an unfortunate thing that I'm hearing from so many women who have had their tubes tied when they were really young, and maybe that was the best birth control option at the time, but I really, really encourage you, if you haven't had your tubes tied and you're thinking about having your tubes tied, like really, really sitting with that, because we do change and we do want different things 20 years later. And often I'm hearing from women in their late 30s and their early 40s who desperately, desperately long for a child, and they've had their tubes tied, and beyond surgical reversal, which doesn't always work and is expensive, it's challenging. So I hope for young women to be more informed about different kinds of birth control before getting their tubes tied. So moving forward, I will tell you that for tubal blockage, these things actually work, but it's not the kind of thing that you could do once or twice. You know, blockage takes years and years and years to build up, and it can take many months to clear out. So I don't want to give you false hopes that you'll do the womb massage or the moxa or drink the tea for like 2 weeks or a month even, and everything will be clear. Sometimes it does work in that short a time, but it really depends on how much blockage you have. So I 100% encourage you to start doing womb massage. I have a womb healing oil that really penetrates in, using castor oil also. You can also just use like your favorite essential oils, but some are better than others, specifically for womb. While you're home, if you don't want to go out and get stuff or order stuff, you can use like olive oil, or I would not use like a artificially scented oil. Like I'd use like pure essential oils, which is what's in all of my products, organic and pure essential oils. And like food grade oils, because this is being absorbed into your body. So you don't want to put anything on your skin that you wouldn't drink. I mean, obviously you don't want to drink essential oil. Some people do, but I don't recommend that. On my YouTube channel also, there's a tutorial for womb massage. That's about 15 minutes long. And there's also one for how to set up your castor oil pack. So I really encourage you to start doing that and getting your hands on your abdomen, your womb. Start really doing this like while you're not distracted, like don't be watching TV while you're doing it, like really bring your energy in, and then you can actually feel with your hands and also internally like where you have tension and stagnation. I also recommend doing moxa because moxa can actually cut through scar tissue. They've done studies with it. It's mugwort, which is also in a lot of my blends. It's going to be in my yoni steam, which is coming out. I'm excited for that, so stay tuned for that. Mugwort is a magical womb healing herb plant. I'm like in love with her, him, I don't know. But anyway, this is moxa. So this is it in a pole form. It's been processed and put into a pole form so you can light it. I don't have a lighter out here. Usually I'll take a candle. I'll hold it into the candle because it could take a while to light. And you want to get it to be on fire. And then you'll blow it out. So that it stays lit, but it's not on fire, like incense, you know, it'll like stay lit. There'll be like the ember part, but it's not a flame. and then you'll hold it on the different points. Whenever you order moxa from me, you'll get a chart that'll come in your email. So keep an eye out in your email, look in your junk mailbox, because sometimes it goes there with pictures of all the places to do it and like another description of how to do it. You could also do this on your partner if he's got any like sperm issues. But for, especially for Fallopian tube blockage, I encourage you to hold it over different points on your low abdomen. So you can kind of go up from your pubic bone, which is right in the middle, like that bone right above your vagina, basically, and then your hip bone out to the side. And then right in between there, you can hold this. You don't touch it to your skin, because obviously it'll burn you. You hold it about an inch away from your skin. And for blockage, you could do like little pecking. Don't touch your skin, but just hold it about an inch away and the smoke will kind of penetrate in, and eventually it'll get too hot, and then you can move on to the other side, let that side get too hot, and then move back and forth until it's just too hot and you're done. So maybe like 5-10 minutes a day would be great. If you have more of like the kind of fertility where you're not getting pregnant because you have some deficiency, some like womb deficiency, you'd actually do slow circles as opposed to pecking. So, but since we're talking about fallopian tube blockage, definitely the pecking. As far as the tea that's best for blockage, it would be the bitch's brew tea, because it's the most blood and chi moving, the most invigorating. It'll kind of get into your womb and kind of start moving things out. So some women, when they start to drink the tea, they might start to feel some cramping, some twinges, they might spot, they might even bleed a little bit. This is actually really good. It's like all that stuff that's been in there that's stuck is moving. So you might feel that whenever there's kind of blockage that's being moved, it's like being pushed against. It can be a little crampy. So that's totally okay and actually a good sign. Some women reach out to me and like are like, I'm cramping, is this dangerous or bad? And no, it's actually really, really good. And just bring awareness to it, like notice what you feel. So that is what I have to share with you today. It feels actually good to say hi, and you guys are seeing me like first thing in the morning. My hair is kind of crazy, although it always is. No makeup. But yeah, it's good to see you guys, and hopefully this answered some of your questions. And please be patient with us during this time. We're all doing our best. Be patient with yourself too. It's a challenging time, and really grateful to be able to connect with you. So enjoy the rest of your weekend. Bye.